So is that our goal, the records room? I guess so. Information? Question mark. Awesome. Come on in, guys. Oh, dead person. Sublight thug. Protective clothing with safety harness gold. Hemlock's eye patch. This eye patch is comfortable, stylish, and a conversation piece. Reversible for left or right eye use. Also available in mauve and top. Gives you sneak attack damage. Eh. I'll break it down. Let's not let things from outside interrupt. Piecemeal mining helmet. Really low, yeah.
That's impressive.
500 bits. That's impressive. 13, 37, 44, 50, 44, 60. It's like they couldn't fit it all in there and just left it sitting out. Old data cartridge. Found in the remains of an old outpost on Monarch. Given the rust, the sulfur degradation, and the years spent sitting in dirt and dust, it'll be a miracle if anything would be found on it. Still, Zora would be interested to see it. We got it. Still wondering why this is called sucker bait. Guess we got everything. Oh, but there's a thing over there. Oh, we got these too. Yeah, I can't leave this out. I love forgetting these. This substation has been decommissioned following the closure of work order number UDL-211. Communications functionality has been disabled. Logs and messages have been archived. Messages. The following messages are available for retrieval. Work order UDL-211 status report number 1. Recording engineer status report number 1. Recording engineer Walkowitz. Tunnels are in, cables are laid. Devil's Peak is receiving, but we're waiting on signal confirmation from the outpost. This whole place stinks of sulfur. We should have brought masks. I'm sure I heard something in the caverns beneath the tower. There's caverns down there. Wonderful. Something's living there. Here's hoping we don't unsettle it, or else that place ain't gonna be safe for our cable guys. Status report number 2. We've got signal from Amber Heights, Stellar Bay, and Cascadia. Still waiting on word from Bayside Terrace and Aurora Ridge. Aurora Ridge, we haven't been there yet. I ought to note that I was right about those caverns. They ain't safe. Some kind of, hell, I don't know, a big thing with claws. I ain't an animal scientist. Can't wait to get the hell off this rock. Closure of work order. Work order number UDL-211 has been completed. This substation will now be disabled and closed off. It should be noted that the lead engineer, Franklin Walkowitz, has perished due to a workplace accident involving hostile wildlife in the Devil's Peak Caverns. It should be further noted that Walkowitz's complaints regarding the dangers of the Terra 1 wildlife have been redacted. Oh, so he's dead, so you remove his complaints that led to his... You guys are wonderful. Halcyon Referendum Number 207, Terra 1 Hazard Clause. Public notice number 117 on the issuing of a hazard clause for Terra 1. Is this the same thing? The announcement of Terra 1 as a feasible workspace environment. I read this somewhere else. Yeah. Yep, this is the same thing we read a couple episodes ago. At the printing press. Manual log entry. Gonna die for this damn fool, Arend. I know it. He said Amber Heights was gonna have more bits than we can spend, but those suited morons up and spent it all for us. Books and vases and pretty stuff. You can't eat a book. Look at us now. Of all the closets to coop in and lick our wounds, coop up in and lick our wounds, we had to choose the one that's set to lock itself up. Feel like a marauder digging at the walls like this, but we gotta get out before we starve. It ain't possible, but Nelson over there is trying to keep our spirits up, and I don't got the energy to fight him on it. Screw that Bryant fella. Eyes bigger than his stomach. Closets. So the closet locked itself with them inside and they're digging at the walls. What? Nothing else, right? No. That's crazy. Is this the place that they couldn't get out of? Or is there somewhere else that they wrote? I guess they must have wrote it here. They couldn't leave? They got stuck in here? There's only one body. There's supposedly a Nelson and somebody else. Whoever was writing it. Maybe it was written from another terminal. I couldn't say. We haven't been everywhere that yet, though. There's at least an upstairs here. Overhauled power helmet. Mm. Another 70 bits. Any more stairs leading up? Over here, maybe? Actually, I don't know how we'd get up there. Right, never mind. Return to Zora. You found a suspicious data cartridge. This may be what Zora was looking for. Which is that? Alright, let's head back. Luckily we can just go back. Boop. Look at those teethies.
I don't know what it is, but my gun's been acting funny. It used to be I had to correct for a bit of leftward drag. Got used to standing just so, and after a while it put a thorn in my side, something awful. Lately, though, it ain't pulling. I find my stance much improved.
Oh, that's real good to hear. It took me a while to, never mind.
She's in here.
What? Girl, have you been touching my stuff?
I'm sorry. I should have asked. I just got real bored, and I seen you leaning, and the gun was sitting right there.
You know, the last time I caught someone messing with my equipment, I threw him in a sulfur pool. But I appreciate the help. You want to make modifications? Just come ask me, all right? I ain't gonna bite.
Unless you don't ask her. Then she will bite. Guess what I got?
Welcome back. You find anything out there?
There's a bunch of junk. Old cartridges and the like.
Let's see. These are old. Looks like correspondences between the pirates.
This is old.
Some bits here, some there, some... Wait. This one's got the Amber Heights gate code on it. Just like the one I found earlier. And here's... a letter. Wait, this is from Graham.
Graham?
Oh, of all the... Captain. He gave them the gate codes.
I don't know what to say. Well, you gotta admit, Graham isn't exactly known for his rationality.
Watch it. That's our leader you're talking about. My friend.
Oh god, you'll say it to him.
I know he's got his head in the clouds, but I always believed there was a core of good there. What the hell happened to live and let live? Thank you for bringing this back, but I need some time. I gotta think. I'll let you know if I figure something out.
Oh, trouble in paradise. Well, it's not like you haven't had a problem with him before.
Go take a walk, Captain. I'll find you once my head's on straight.
Should we go find him and talk to him about it? Can we talk to him about it?
Welcome.
I know you're responsible for the Amber Heights massacre.
When I founded the Iconoclasts, I did so amidst the ghosts of this planet's past. Since then, many have asked me, why here? Were you involved in the massacre? Was that some gruesome plot to clear a path for my dreams? My response to you is the same as to all others. The death of MSI was an incidental tragedy. I'd have walked this path with or without it.
You're avoiding the issue. You set pirates on innocent lives.
I did no such thing. Their deaths came in the night while I slept in Stellar Bay. And regardless, we're discussing a past long since left behind. Those ghosts still haunt me. But they needn't curse my people. When the entire colony has embraced our truth, perhaps then the perpetrator will come into the light. Until then, it does us no good to dwell on past mistakes.
For the sake of argument, why do you imagine the perpetrator might have done it?
If I were the type of man to make that decision, and I assure you I am not, I'd have to be so obsessed with dismantling their regime that I'd turn to desperate measures. I have since learned that their mistakes will end them in time, and that we will persevere where they do not. But back then, suffocating under that oppressive culture, I can understand a lesser man than myself making a terrible, ghastly mistake.
You're avoiding the question. Why did they deserve it?
If MSI had abandoned this place and taken to Terra 2, any hope for our salvation would have been lost. Here, without the shackles of the Halcyon board, we are free to grow as the universe intended. Had we fled with MSI, our spirits would have withered. You've seen that withering yourself. The colony is dying. The massacre of Amber Heights, unfortunate as it was, presented the slim possibility of saving the souls of Terra 2. Here we are, poised to do just that.
Well, you can't just play judge, jury, and executioner like that.
Free will is a double-edged sword, Captain. The universe judges us all. Whether your choices are helpful or harmful to the cosmos is not up to you. Those executives were found to be poisonous to the spirit of humanity. They were doomed, whether by the hands of man or beast, their time was coming to an end. And here I am, a paragon of the eternal truth, leading a society of like-minded people. The universe has found me worthy, despite whatever sins you believe I've committed. Let us speak no more of this, Captain. We have a message to spread and a colony to save. The cool evening air refreshes my spirit and brings only the faintest hint of sulfur.
Glad you feel so good about things.
All right. Why have you come?
To point the finger at you. Well, I'm afraid Zora is going to be having a talk with you shortly.
Go take a walk, Captain. I'll find you once my head's on straight.
Okay. What do we have left to do? I wonder if we can get some more ammo. These machines over here. We can! Got a good amount of ammo. So, what else do we have to do? Oh, that's near the relay station. The way we can't fast travel to the relay station. All this stuff's pretty far out. Fulbert Crossroads. We can just fast travel there and then find this Mr. Pickett, I guess. Diet toothpaste. I think I hear it, possibly. Mr. Pickett? Question mark? Getting closer. Well, that water looks like you could actually swim in it. Not that I feel a need to. There's a manta queen right there as well. You guys ready? How's my weapon doing? Oh, it's always getting banged up. I should have repaired it while I was in town. I should put mods on it while I was in town, too. Mr. Pickett's there, but there's a manta queen right there, so maybe we'll get some practice.
All together. I've got a hurt.
Wow. Oh, there's stuff. Manta swarm? I'm still reloading, unfortunately. Not too bad at all. I was really kind of afraid of the manta queens, but it's not too bad. It's a good target, you know. You can't miss the thing, especially with the scope. This guy's close. I wonder if that was the manta queen that he was hunting, or that. Has it gotten the better of him or something? To find a manta queen. Or if there's another manta queen over here somewhere. It's like hiding or something, nesting as.
Else it would have been a hell of a lot tougher.
Ow.
I almost hit that.
Ow. Mr. Pickett's journal. This journal details Mr. Pickett's ill-timed trip to Stellar Bay just before the hazard clause went into effect and his attempts to hunt a manta queen to bring to Edgewater. I heard you. You were drinking. Oh, heading back. Stellar Bay Ruins South. That was a nice quick one. Slices, dices, cauterizes. The Plasma Cutter. You can be both admired and feared by the same faction. They are not mutually exclusive, really. Not every challenge needs to be solved by a gun. They can be handled through negotiation or staff. So let's deal with Sebastian. Ooh.
You look like a woman who's looking for some mostly fresh animal parts.
You know, can I? I can't read this journal, can I? Let me just take a look here. I guess I can't. Yeah, I can't read it. Alright. I want to.
You look like a woman who's looking for
something. I got the journal.
He'll probably be wanting it back. You see any sign of him?
Well, I found the journal inside a dead manta queen.
Funny place to leave a journal. But what about Mr. Pickett?
How do I know the guy escaped? So I'm either assuming that he's dead, or I'm assuming he escaped. Well, it wouldn't just eat his journal. He would be holding the journal, and it'd be eating him. So, he was eaten by a manta queen. He's dead, and all that's left is that journal.
That's pretty sad. He sure seemed like he knew what he was doing.
He used to tell the kids crazy stories about Halcyon wildlife. Later I learned most of it was wrong, but it was the thought that counted. Then one day, he just disappeared. Never heard anything about him again.
Anyone fool enough to chase after a queen is pretty fucking far from the know-what-they're-doing class of people.
So this journal is all he left behind? Seems like I ought to read it. Looks mighty long, though.
I think they already went on a date. Maybe focus on not sending anyone else out alone against the Manta Queen.
You ought to know how dangerous that is.
Yeah, you're probably right. In any case, I appreciate you tracking down Mr. Pickett for me. Here's some bits for your trouble.
Well, thanks. Anything else we need to talk about?
Hmm? Like what?
Nothing, actually. Yes! I leveled up. Alright, so we're gonna put... K for character? I actually remembered it. Can't rebind those keys. Pretty stupid. This we can't do. We can increase range and defense. So I'm gonna get range to 50 like that. So now we have to specialize after that. We're gonna put into defense. And then starting with the next level, I'll have 5 points left after filling this defense up. Specialize in something. Have some ideas on what I want, where I want to put that, but we'll work on that when we get there. Okay. Let's work on this stuff here. We modify my hunting rifle. Crit damage. Or whisper quiet. Yeah, crit damage. Well, how about what we got? We got extendo sight and weapon. We got extendo sight, basically. And we got gyro sight. So, what do we want for the magazine? Probably just gonna increase the ammo? Corrosion? I guess the ammo. And then for the barrel, critical damage. Or if it reduces the noise, can I kill something in a group and not have them go after me? I'm not sure. Let's increase the critical damage. Sweet. This is one killer gun, telling you. The assault rifle already have all this stuff on it. Is this light assault rifle? Who's holding what? Nioka has a light machine gun. Parvati has a light assault rifle. So maybe we can modify their stuff. I think I read that stuff. Yeah. This is all we can do? Magazine mod, that's all we can do on it. Alright. Pretty limited. Crit damage? Yeah, crit damage. Thank you. Mount Magnum. Magazine size. I don't know if the sight helps with them. I don't know if it would make her more effective. Let me just give her the gyro one then. This is Parvati's. Power grip. Mr. Ouch, okay. Oh, this, okay. Okay. Alright, we're done with that. So now, maybe I want to tinker a little bit more. Oh. I can't even. About my assault rifle ultra. Yeah, I'm gonna stop here. Let's repair this stuff. Well, can I tinker with the armor, actually? $1177 bits now. Help my crew, you know? Yeah, we're running out. Okay, we're done. I'm kind of broke. Kind of broke right now. Look at our quests. We don't have that many. This is up the Devil's Peak. This is on Scylla. This is on Scylla. This is the outpost. I'm going to do that soon. That's meeting with Catherine. Hayes Grave. Where is that? Reginald. Is in Fallbrook also. I guess with, yeah, Catherine. Just wanna look. See what this says. Okay. Yeah. A little past there. Okay, so we're gonna meet with Catherine next episode. It was right here. We can just fast travel right there. So thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.